A warm welcome to all of you watching at home to today's Azerbaijan Grand Prix, and a race that in its short history has already proven no stranger to drama. A fourth row start is just about as likely to give you a podium as a pole position would. And remember, in 2017 and 2018, both Lance Stroll and then Sergio Perez took surprise podiums here. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position, and Lando Norris lines up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Bottas, Sergio Perez, and Leclerc, Sainz, Gasly, Tsunoda, and Sebastian Vettel. Fernando Alonso, Hamilton, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Lance Stroll and Giovinazzi. Moore, Raikkonen, George Russell and Mick Schumacher. Latifi and Nikita Mazepin. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. To manage this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode. There's been an incident on track resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed to clear it up in time, and there are no plans for a safety car right now.
Drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everyone at the team. Performance, making gains at the top of the table. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Well, for me, it's got to be Lewis Hamilton. The multiple world champion may be the boring choice at this point, but you can't argue that he's a driver deserving of his reputation.
Let's move on to the constructors. Red Bull take over as championship leaders. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
Well, things didn't really go your way today. Let's have your take. It looked like you had a few mechanical hiccups during that race.
It must be crushing when something goes wrong that's entirely out of your control.
Appreciate your time.
Fernando is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 6.3 seconds. Their best lap time is a 1 minute 9.
Good day today. Let's have your take on it.
You won't be starting at the front of the pack. Are you worried?
There are rumours that you're looking... Thank you.
Hello and welcome to the Ile Notre Dame once again for what promises to be another incredible Canadian Grand Prix at a fiercely competitive circuit, where pole position can often be decided by less than a tenth of a second. With top speeds of around 210 miles per hour heading into the overtaking opportunity of turn 13, the 2.7 miles of the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve are some of the quickest on the Formula One calendar. There are 14 corners in total, with 60% of the lap taken at full throttle, and average lap speeds clock in at about 130 miles per hour. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat, Anthony Davidson. Ant, our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching for as they go down into turn one?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into turn one as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position, edging out Sergio Perez, who lines up P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Verstappen, Hamilton, Lando Norris, and Gasly, Fernando Alonso, Ricciardo, Vettel, and Charles Leclerc. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Stroll, Sainz, Moore and Raikkonen, Russell, Giovinazzi, Nicholas Latifi and Nikita Mazepin, Mick Schumacher and Yuki Tsunoda. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track. We'll be right back.
race over, take care of the car on the way in.
Victory for the team from Milton Keynes then, after a quality performance. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I'd say it was down once again to good, consistent driving, nailing the corners, working to the track conditions and perfecting the team's strategies. They got all of these things right today and the results speak for themselves.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently. It's clear to see that they've put in the work and they should be proud of the victory they secured here. With his performance, making gains at the top of the table. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Carlos Sainz certainly wasn't someone to scoff about. His ability to follow race strategies throughout with pinpoint precision has to be commended.
Let's move on to the constructors. Red Bull pulled further ahead in the standings. Meanwhile, AlphaTauri's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.